Inside your house, there is something dying a slow death needlessly. It is dying only because you are neglecting it. One of the things that drives me the most crazy when it comes to water heaters is how everybody treats them like they're disposable. What if I told you you are being lied to about your water heater? You ever heard anybody tell you they're only going to last 10 to 13 years? Even home inspectors, all of our standard reports and narratives say, oh, the typical water heater lasts anywhere between 10 and 13 years. I once inspected a house that had a water heater that was in perfect working order from 1964. Let me tell you all about how to keep your water heater running for a long time. A water heater is one of the most expensive components in your home. They have only gotten more expensive over the last 5 years. In fact, just the cost of the water heater alone is over $1,000 now, and getting a plumber to come install it, I had a client tell me yesterday that her brand new water heater cost her over $5,000. So the $1 million question, why do we treat them like they're disposable? So here it is, everything you ever wanted to know about how to keep your water heater in good running order. Water heater I told you about from 1964, they flushed it annually, and they wrote on the side of the water heater with a felt marker every single date that they flushed it. And it was listed across the water heater in columns all the way around the outside of that water heater. I was impressed. Every single year they flushed the water heater and they changed the anode rod. All right, now usually when you flush a water heater, you will see a bunch of gunk come out of this hose and it'll just look like a bunch of rusty, corroded water coming out of this thing. But here's the big secret. When I just flushed this water heater, only clear water came out. And want me to tell you why? Because of that right there. That is a powered anode rod. All right, so buckle up. I'm going to show you how to install this thing because it only takes a couple minutes. It's something nobody ever talks about, how important the anode rod is inside your water heater. It actually stops all that corrosion from occurring inside the water heater, and the corrosion is what destroys these. Now, if you're like me and you don't really want to have to change that anode rod every year and pay for a new one, it's much easier to go with a powered anode rod. And you guys know me. I swear by Coro Protect powered anode rods.
6 months earlier.
All right, so today we're working on a Whirlpool water heater. Many of you have a Whirlpool, and you'll notice up here there's these two caps. This one's actually pretty easy because this little label right here says anode. All right, so if you come over here and you pull this cap out, I've already done it, but you'll see a bunch of insulation in here. And usually you have to kind of pry out the insulation and dig down until you find the anode itself. And you'll see that hex head right there. That's when you take the proper socket size and you loosen that up. Now, this is finger loose because I already loosened it, but you'll need a ratchet or a tool for this. All right, so let's pull this anode rod out and see what it looks like. And maybe we'll see why this water smells like rotten eggs. This is inside the water heater. That's the water that you're drinking and showering in. Yeah, how's that look? We'll just keep pulling this out. It's getting stuck. And there you go. There's your beautiful anode rod. Now, the reason I like the powered anode rods is because you don't have to maintain them at all. You put them in and forget about them, and they will help make your water heater last a long time. They're going to make your water quality better. I mean, I just absolutely love these things. So today we're going to drop this in, and within the next day, we're going to watch all that sulfur smell disappear. All right, you tighten this up. These are actually super easy to install. Right here, there's one plug. The plug that it comes with has this end that plugs in right here, and this end needs to be grounded, and I'll show you how to do that, because you really just come over and loosen one of these screws. Connect the ground connector and tighten this up. Plug this in right here. And then plug this into an outlet. And that is really all there is to it. I am never going to have to worry about that anode rod ever again. There you have it. That's how you get rid of the sulfur smell in your water, you improve your water quality, and you make your water heater last a very long time. Inside your house, there is something dying a slow death needlessly. It is dying only because you are neglecting it. One of the things that drives me the most crazy when it comes to water heaters is how everybody treats them like they're disposable. What if I told you you are being lied to about your water heater? You ever heard anybody tell you they're only going to last 10 to 13 years? Even home inspectors, all of our standard reports and narratives say, oh, the typical water heater lasts anywhere between 10 and 13 years. I once inspected a house that had a water heater that was in perfect working order from 1964. Let me tell you all about how to keep your water heater running for a long time. A water heater is one of the most expensive components in your home. They have only gotten more expensive over the last 5 years. In fact, just the cost of the water heater alone is over $1,000 now, and getting a plumber to come install it, I had a client tell me yesterday that her brand new water heater cost her over $5,000. So, the $1 million question, why do we treat them like they're disposable? So here it is, everything you ever wanted to know about how to keep your water heater in good running order. Water heater I told you about from 1964, they flushed it annually, and they wrote on the side of the water heater with a felt marker every single date that they flushed it. And it was listed across the water heater in columns all the way around the outside of that water heater. I was impressed. Every single year they flushed the water heater and they changed the anode rod. All right, now usually when you flush a water heater, you will see a bunch of gunk come out of this hose and it'll just look like a bunch of rusty, corroded water coming out of this thing. But here's the big secret. When I just flushed this water heater, only clear water came out. And want me to tell you why? Because of that right there. That is a powered anode rod. All right, so buckle up. I'm going to show you how to install this thing because it only takes a couple minutes. This is something nobody ever talks about, how important the anode rod is inside your water heater. It actually stops all that corrosion from occurring inside the water heater, and the corrosion is what destroys these. Now, if you're like me and you don't really want to have to change that anode rod every year and pay for a new one, it's much easier to go with a powered anode rod. And you guys know me. I swear by Coro Protect powered anode rods.
6 months earlier.
All right, so today we're working on a Whirlpool water heater. Many of you have a Whirlpool, and you'll notice up here there's these two caps. This one's actually pretty easy because this little label right here says anode. All right, so if you come over here and you pull this cap out, I've already done it, but you'll see a bunch of insulation in here. And usually you have to kind of pry out the insulation and dig down until you find the anode itself. And you'll see that hex head right there. That's when you take the proper socket size and you loosen that up. Now, this is finger loose because I already loosened it, but you'll need a ratchet or a tool for this. All right, so let's pull this anode rod out and see what it looks like. And maybe we'll see why this water smells like rotten eggs. This is inside the water heater. That's the water that you're drinking and showering in. Yeah, how's that look? We'll just keep pulling this out. Let's get stuck. And there you go. There's your beautiful anode rod. Now, the reason I like the powered anode rods is because you don't have to maintain them at all. You put them in and forget about them, and they will help make your water heater last a long time. They're going to make your water quality better. I mean, I just absolutely love these things. So today we're going to drop this in, and within the next day, we're going to watch all that sulfur smell disappear. All right, you tighten this up. These are actually super easy to install. Right here, there's one plug. The plug that it comes with has this end that plugs in right here, and this end needs to be grounded, and I'll show you how to do that, because you really just come over and loosen one of these screws. Connect the ground connector and tighten this up. Plug this in right here. And then plug this into an outlet. And that is really all there is to it. I am never going to have to worry about that anode rod ever again. There you have it. That's how you get rid of the sulfur smell in your water, you improve your water quality, and you make your water heater last a very long time.